I have the fortunate job of being music director at this church. And it's my delight to coordinate with the Bayview Music Festival over these years. I grew up in Bayview, did a lot of singing and performing there as a singer and a pianist, and now it's my delight to sit back and listen to great singers and great instrumentalists throughout the season. We're very honored tonight to host a very special program. We did it last year as well, the spirit was intensive, and I see many repeat faces. It's great having a wonderful audience here. I hope you'll in for a treat. I take this out of the visual cue. If you are one of those who owns one of these, please turn it on silent. The other day I was in a wedding rehearsal with mine went off. I'm a little embarrassed. It's my great pleasure to introduce to you Riz Renee Harmon, a good friend who's a soprano on staff at Bayview and also director of vocal studies, and she will introduce the group.
I will not be a liar, no, I'll tell you the reason. situations in our country's history. But now these songs have been turned into concert songs, and they are sung all over the world by church choirs, by university choirs, by professional choirs. They are America's folk music, and nowhere else in the world can lay claim to American Negro spirituals but the United States. And so they are a very popular form of music, and they are sought after. These spirituals are sung in many places. There are over 6,000 Negro melodies, and so the intensive this week is to help the students to learn the history of these songs, and also to learn about spirituals and where they came from and how they were born, so that they can be the next generation to take it on, because they will be the people who will transmit this music to the next generation. And so it's been a joy this week for me to work with them and to enjoy their beautiful voices. So we hope you enjoy the program tonight. The next is Great Day. The composer is Moses.
Thank you. Thank you.
out to Dvorak to see if he would come and be his headmaster, his director. He agreed with the provision that he be allowed to accept the newly freed slaves into his conservatory. And so the lady agreed to this, and he came over in 1890, and he accepted several black students. One of them was a man by the name of Harry T. Burley. Burley wrote the very famous Deep River, which is a spiritual that many people know and sing. Dvorak wrote his most famous piece in this country. It was called Symphony for a New World. And in the preface of the symphony, Dvorak wrote that in the music of the Native Americans and in the American blacks, that you had all that was needed to create an entirely new school of music. Well, this sent shockwaves around the world that this very famous Czech composer had to come to America to tell America about music that was already here, but that had not been regarded as serious music. But Dvorak knew the importance of it because he had made his career in Czechoslovakia by taking folk, Czech folk melodies and making them into string quartets, into symphonies, into songs. And so he knew the power of folk music. And so when he came here, he encouraged his composers to take this folk music and make it into classical music, very similar to what he had done in the Czech Republic, in the Czechoslovakia. And so the spirituals in their present form, we owe a lot to Antonín Dvořák for seeing the importance of this music and how this music can be important to this country. This next piece, We Shall Walk Through the Valley, in peace, is by Moses Hogan, and he has continued this wonderful tradition of taking these beautiful spirituals and fashioning beautiful arrangements. We hope you enjoy.
We shall walk. Thank you. Capital University, Columbus, Ohio, and I'm 22. and get yourself.
Thank you.
untold, and justice was denied. Make them hear. Make them hear. Make them hear.